snow. Such is, so it rains and snows over the mountain, leaving the land on the other side as dry as a desert. No fair, why should the mountains get all the water? Anybody got an umbrella? It's my parachute, please. Not parachutes, shoot. Without warning, Miss Frizzle leaned on the lever and the bus took a nosedive. Ah, everyone cried. Everyone except Arnold. That is, he was always ready for a field trip. Several guides. Field trip number 63. He said, in the event of a rapid loss of altitude, you may put on a parachute. That was a close one. You said it. We were almost about to crash, but the Frizz flipped the switch and the school bus changed into an all-terrain desert vehicle. At the very last minute, we rolled to a smooth stop. Ooh, that was close. The sun in the desert was hot, hot, hot. We all started to sweat, except for Ms. Frizzle. She always keeps her cool. Above us, a vulture. A few encircled, but Miss Frizzle didn't seem to notice. Come along, class, she said. We're here to experience the desert. Take chances. Make mistakes. Get dusty. Is it just me, or does this look like our final field trip? Come on, you guys. We've got to save the animals. Whoa. What now? Don't give her any more ideas, Phoebe. Before long, we spied a hungry roadrunner chasing a colored lizard across the desert sand. Quick, Phoebe explained, everyone back in the bus. We have to save the lat lizard. Miss Frizzle eyes lit into an idea. A situation worth exploration, Phoebe, she said. Inside the bus, Miss Frizzle pulled a lever. The bus started shrinking. It started into a Gila monster. And now the Roadrunner was after us. Miss Frizzle stepped on the gas pedal hard, as I always say, when the going gets hungry, the hungry gets going. Cool, We're a Gila monster. This is bad, bad, bad. I hate field trips where we get eaten.
It's the boss.
A few minutes later, the Roadrunner scooped us up